This episode is sponsored by Flawless, a Texas-based natural skincare line for all skin types started by a friend of mine from undergrad, Bianca. After we graduated from university, Bianca had broken out with cystic acne, dry, peeling, irritated skin, and had scabs and scars all over her face. She tried different skincare methods and skincare lines for about 3.5 years with no success. That's when she remembered the idea of Flawless that God gave her almost 4 years prior, and she started making her own natural soaps. The name Flawless came from the Bible verse Song of Solomon, chapter 4, verse 7, which says, "You are altogether beautiful, my love. There is no flaw in you." I started using Flawless because I wanted to clear my face as I saw it had for Bianca. And let me tell you, this has done the trick. What I like about these products is that everything is handcrafted. Her soaps are made in small batches to ensure the highest level of quality, and they're free of parabens, phthalates, and sodium lauryl sulfate. They're also slowly cured using the traditional cold process method, and they use oils, milks, purees, and moisturizing butters to make your skin look and feel flawless. If you're looking for skincare products that are made with care using ingredients you trust, go to www.flawlessnaturalsoaps.com and use my referral code VERSEBASSO to get 10% off all purchases over $10. Choose Flawless and be reminded just how beautiful you are in the eyes of God.
You're listening to First Basso.
Hello and welcome to First Basso, a show where we learn together how to take that first basso toward becoming the best versions of ourselves. My name is Candace Olushola, and it is 2 days away from the first day of 2021. I don't feel like we're at the end of 2020. I'm hoping we're not about to step into 2020 part two, but I will say, knowing that my calendar is not lying to me, I've been thinking a lot about everything that has happened personally, nationally, and globally in 2020. First off, we came into 2020 saying, "Ooh, the roaring 20s are back," and boy, did they roar. That growl was a lot. We thought 2020 would be the year of clarity and vision and being able to step into our best selves. And yeah, that happened to a lot of people. And I'm going to be honest, I feel like that was the year that I had overall. But I can't pretend like everyone had a year like me. A lot of people lost their loved ones. People had illness like they've never had before. Financial burden like they've never had before. Isolation like they've never had before. Mental health declined for many. Some people who hadn't experienced a real issue with depression or anxiety, panic attacks. This was the year to have them. And from the natural disasters at the beginning of the year to the world going on lockdown to people trying to figure out what this virus is, conspiracy theories, doubt, fear, frustration, anger. We've gone through an entire spectrum of emotions and experiences this year. And it was so back to back to back to back to back that it almost felt like there was no end in sight. It's been so much. I felt guilty in seasons of this year, experiencing my own little oasis of joy and peace and growth and breakthrough just from fasting and praying and running after God this year with my cousin, who had asked me at the beginning of the year to do that with her. And I told you guys a few podcasts back that my year was redemption, restoration, and rejuvenation in Christ Jesus. And I had that this year. I had that the whole year from top to bottom. And so I'm so thankful for what I went through, but I know that some are still processing an experience that does not look or did not look anything like mine. And I'm not saying that I didn't experience loss. I did lose dear loved ones to COVID this year, to other diseases this year, and couldn't visit them. It's been heavy and light. It's been a mix, I think, for me personally, and some people's ratios are different from others, and that's okay. But I don't want you to be scared to step into 2021 desiring to be your best self. Yeah, we're scarred and traumatized by a lot of what happened in 2020. Yeah, we're probably also pissed off by a lot of things that happened in 2020. And some of that's going to carry on into 2021. We can't be ignorant that once the clock strikes 12, we're going to meet a prince somewhere and run off into the sunset. It's not going to be that. There's going to be a transition period for all of us. We don't know what new normal is going to look like. We don't know how long some places are going to have to recover or rebuild their economies, their communities. And we don't have the answers to what's coming. But we can choose to have a mindset that if I can get through 2020, gosh darn it, I'm going to get through anything at this point. So I really encourage you guys to still take that time, whether you have a journal, a planner, your notes section in your phone, whatever it is that you have, to try and reflect on this year, as painful as it might be for some of you. Remember, this podcast is about taking steps that will take us into a direction we want to go. And sometimes that requires us to reflect on things that we don't want to, in order to grasp the lessons we need from those to be able to propel ourselves into our future. So get out a piece of paper, write down the blessings and the tragedies of 2020, write down the lessons that you've learned, plan out your first week, first month, the whole year of 2021. If you're a believer in God, or if you're desiring to understand who God is, take the time to say a prayer before the year is over. Seek out some community towards the end of this year to kind of talk to you about how you're processing the year that you just had. But also have a little bit of time by yourself to just process and choose to look into 2021, not with fear, not with anxiety, but with an open mind that you will try your best to learn as many lessons as 2021 has to offer you. Whether those lessons be positive or negative, you're going to learn something and you're going to grow. But let's hope that there are more positives next year than not. I hope that the first few podcast episodes that I've done for you this year have been beneficial, that you've learned more about yourself, and we're going to keep going on this journey together. I'm excited to keep taking this first Basel experience for myself as a podcaster and growing as an influencer into my future and seeing where we go together, because this journey is not so much about me, but about us helping each other become better versions of ourselves. So I'm learning from you guys as listeners, growing as a person for myself because of the things that you guys share with me, either as guests or as frequent flyers of First Basel. And thank you for challenging me in this step during such a crazy year gave me my own personal escape every week, and I hope to deliver better in 2021. I hope that you continue to support me in listening, subscribing, leaving a star rating and review on whichever podcast site that you listen to this on, and I hope that you share some of your favorites with other people and hold conversations. Maybe go back to a podcast episode that really got you thinking this year and use that as something to springboard your vision of 2021 off of. However I can help, let me know, reach out. You can reach out on my personal IG page at Candy, C-A-N-D-I-E, the number 4, and then J-C, Candy for J-C. You can also reach out to me on all of my social media platforms as First Bossel, which now, if you've been listening to other episodes previously, I have finally gotten my IG for First Bossel to match that of all the other ones, because before it was First _ Bossel. And now I got to claim First Bossel. So now everything is uniform. You can find me at First Bossel on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. And you can find me in Clubhouse as well. If you guys are on Clubhouse, at Candy for JC. Would love to connect with you guys. And thank you for doing this journey with me so far. And I hope that in coming with me into 2021... that we can enjoy what's coming in our future and lean into each other to make sure that we're all getting the best of what's to come. So if you like this episode, please let me know on my social media platforms. Email me, hola, H-O-L-A, at firstbossel.com. You can go on my website, www.firstbossel.com. You can also comment on any of the posts that I make on social media with any questions. Interact with me. I want to hear from you guys. I want to speak with you guys. I love talking to you guys. You can even DM me privately if it's something personal. Send me other ideas of things that you want discussed here, and I will try to serve you guys better each week as best as I can as I grow in Minecraft as a podcaster. Thank you for believing in me. For those of you who are Patreons or support monetarily, I want to give you a special shout out and say thank you to you guys. If you want to become a Patreon for First Bossel, head over to my website and go on the Patreon tab to sign up to become a Patreon. Until next time, until next year, you guys have a wonderful New Year's Eve, a blessed New Year, and I'll see you guys on the other side. Take care. Bye.